2018 BMW i3s. The BMW i3 is packed with clever engineering. Its carbon fiber passenger cell rides on an aluminum skateboard chassis propelled by an electric motor powered by a lithium-ion battery that can get a range-extending boost from an optional two-cylinder engine. And yet none of that is so far outside the box as the social engineering baked into BMW's first electric car. The i3s interior designers created a zen-inspired cabin to lull drivers into a slower pace, in turn maximizing the battery's range. That philosophy also helps explain why the tall and narrow runabout corners with all the eagerness of a phone booth. As delightfully quirky and original as the i3 is, buyers have largely resisted its pulse-slowing charms. In the United States, BMW sells just a few hundred examples of the i3 every month, a convincing argument that few car buyers are seeking four-wheeled zen. So 4 years into the i3's existence, BMW is retrofitting some sportiness into an S badge onto its electric car with the 2018 BMW i3s. This new model, set to land in dealerships alongside a facelift i3 this month, promises quicker acceleration and livelier handling. Pontiac wasn't wrong, wider is better. Wider tires are the cornerstones of the i3s's upgrades, although don't confuse that with wide tires. These tires are roughly as wide as those on the cheapest subcompact cars, measuring just 175/55R20 in front and 195/50R20 at the rear, making them significantly wider than the standard i3s 155/70R19 rubber at all four corners. The new tires fill out the wheel wells for a more stable-looking stance and increase the vehicle's track by 1.6 inches. The i3s also rides on stiffer springs, dampers, and anti-roll bars, with the body lowered by 0.4 inch compared with the standard i3. The ride quality is well matched to modern roads, although the medieval stone and brick back alleys of Lisbon, Portugal, caused heads to wobble and bob. Corners are met with noticeably flatter body motions, but a parking lot concourse set up by BMW proved the car is no more eager to turn in. It's telling that the tight gymkhana kept speeds below 25 miles per hour. The i3s's compact dimensions lend it a low-speed nimbleness but do nothing for high-speed stability. And even if they're wider, the i3s's tires are the same low-rolling resistance Bridgestone Ecopias as those used on the regular i3, and their relatively low limits mean hustling the i3s is still a pulse-calming affair. The i3s remains so disinterested in aggressive cornering that it's easy to forget this is a rear-wheel drive car with a mid-mounted motor, an electric Porsche Cayman the BMW i3 is not. As an improvement over the i3, though, the i3s seems better positioned to replace the standard car than to merely complement it. More electric pep in its step. Acceleration improves thanks to an additional 14 horsepower and 15 lb-ft of torque versus the standard i3. Easy off-the-line thrust is enabled by a 199 lb-ft torque plateau sustained from 0 to 4,500 rpm. BMW claims that fattening the power and torque curves across the rev range will bring significant improvements in acceleration times. We expect 0 to 60 mph times to drop from 6.6 to 6.3 seconds for the battery electric version. A new sport driving mode is exclusive to the i3s model. Since the dampers are passive units, sport mode has no effect on ride quality, but it does make the steering slightly weightier. More noticeable is how it remaps the accelerator pedals tip in to be unnaturally peppy. For a $3,850 premium, the i3s also can be fitted with the two-cylinder gasoline range extender that allows the BMW to keep moving after the battery is depleted. That car should hit 60 miles per hour in 6.9 seconds. The greater rolling resistance of the wider tires likely will ding efficiency and range for both models. Although BMW hasn't revealed the official numbers, we don't expect the EPA-rated range to change much from the 2017 battery electric model's 114 miles.